Ian Kelly, and I'm the product manager for the Virtual API Cloud. I received an email this morning from Maj saying it was their first time at Virtual API Cloud, and could I help them get started in creating a virtual API from request and response pairs? So I started to think about what I might want to virtualize, and I thought about the Weather Channels API. Theirs is called Weather Underground. So I went over to Weather Underground and got a license key. And I found this current conditions API, and it was current conditions for the United States. And I looked at this current conditions API, and all of this information is, this is the base URL of Weather Underground, and this says, hey, it's the API, and this is my secret key. Not so secret, because I'm showing it to you on the video. But then we have the location of the data. We're looking for conditions. And the query is for California, and the state is in the city of San Francisco. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to Virtual API Cloud, and I'm going to create that from that request and generate a new response. So let me select create an API. I'm going to call this one weather demo. Sample from Weather Channel. We're going to do request response pairs, but of course we could do RAML if there was a RAML specification that they gave us. I'm going to modify this and make this a GET request and set it for the conditions for San Francisco. I'm going to clear these two items here, and let's go and get our sample response. This gave us our sample response. I'll simply copy and paste those contents back into Virtual API Cloud. So now I have my request, which is a GET. I'm looking for conditions, query, California, San Francisco, and format is JSON. And there's my response. So let's create that API in about 2 seconds. It's developed that API for me. And now every time I query that API, it will give me that same static response. I have a little counter that we just added last week that'll show you the number of calls made. And I can use this link here to display the full link of the API to go over and test in something like Postman and be able to make that test from there as well. So now I've virtualized this API for a static result, a static response. I can modify this and create other versions of this, and I'll show that to you in a later video. So that is really quickly how to create a new API from a sample request and response.